Dear friends, and especially our friends from Taiwan, we are very proud to have you here in our home. Of course, the lifting of martial law in Taiwan 20 years ago was a watershed for Taiwan. But I believe that it really went much beyond Taiwan in its significance, because it put paid to the idea that democracy, human rights, individual liberty are issues, are Western values somehow, and cannot be Asian values, as was argued by Lee Kuan Yew and Mahathir, not to mention your friends across the Straits, who argue that democracy really is something that is imposed from the West. It very clearly isn't. It wasn't imposed on Taiwan. It was a choice of the Taiwanese people to get to democracy. It wasn't always easy in those 20 years. But 20 years is, of course, a very short period. If I think of how long it took us to establish democracy in Europe, it has taken centuries to do such a thing in 20 years. Is absolutely amazing. It's not the only amazing thing you're doing in Taiwan, but it's one of the really amazing things. What I also find amazing is that 20 years after the establishment of democracy in Taiwan, which I think arguably is one of the most, if not the most, democratic country in Asia, Taiwan is still treated as sort of the guest that you would rather not see appear at your party. You feel a little bit awkward because there is also this big guy standing in the corner who doesn't want you to appear. And this is really quite odd when, as a European Union, we are trying to promote democracy and good governance across the globe. The one country that symbolizes this in Asia, we say, well, we'd rather not have you around if at all possible. When the European Parliament wanted to invite President Chen to address this parliament, it turned out not to be possible, that the Ministers of Foreign Affairs decided it wasn't really very convenient if he would appear, whereas we put out the red carpet for the Chinese. I have nothing against that, but why not treat Taiwan with more respect and as a part of our international community? You are part of the World Trade Organization, but the World Health Organization, which should not be an area where this type of politics is played out, you are still not able to work in a good way, and this is really something we should work to solve. I'm very pleased to at the end of this reception, or to let the reception be closed by a message which we received today from President Chen himself from Taiwan. He couldn't do it live because he's asleep, I hope, at this moment. But it is an absolutely fresh message. Which will close at least the formal part of this reception. So I would say get a drink and let us toast to Taiwan and listen to the message from President Chen. Thank you.